Good morning, friends. How are you all? So, in the last class, we have studied about the basic concept of fraction. Now, let's move further and talk about fractions in detail. As you see, this is a sheet of paper and it is divided in two halves. Okay, I have shaded the half part of it. Means, in two parts, there is total, how many parts are there? Two parts. So, this denominator tells us what? How many total number of parts are there? Okay, this one shows the number of shaded part. So how many shaded part are there? Only one. So 1/2. Okay, here there are how many total number of parts? There are 4 parts. Okay, how many shaded parts? 4 parts. So it is written as 4/4. Okay, now here as you can see there are how many parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is a one more part attached to it. So how many shaded part? Yes, 5 out of 4. As you see here, 1/2, this numerator is smaller than denominator. Yes, it is smaller than denominator. So it is what? Proper fraction. A fraction which is less than 1. Okay, here 1/2 is smaller than 1. Yes. Therefore, it is called proper fraction. Now, here 4/4 will give you what? 1. And here 5/4, the 5 is greater than 4. So, here the numerator is greater than denominator. So, this fraction, a fraction which is more than 1 is called improper fraction. Here 5/4, it is more than 1. So, this type of fractions are called improper fractions. Now 4/1, this kind of fractions whose answer comes out 1 are also called unit fraction. Okay, whose answer comes out or whose fraction is equal to 1 are called unit fractions. Now we will talk about mixed fraction, a fraction which is a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction. Okay, as you all know that, okay, we have taken an example 1/2, or we can take an example of 3/4, or we can take an example of 5/7. All here are having what? They are all proper fractions because of fraction which is less than 1. Okay, if you divide 3/4, your answer will be what? 0 point something, which is less than 1. So this is also a proper fraction. 5/7 is also a proper fraction. Now if you divide 5/4, you will get 1 point something, means your answer will be more than 1. So it is called improper fraction. And in mixed fraction form, it is what? There is a combination of proper fraction also and combination of a mixed number, whole number. Example 3/2. Here this is called a whole number, and 5/2, this part is called the proper fraction part. So in a mixed fraction or mixed number, there is a combination of a whole number, for example 3 here, and a proper fraction 2/5 here. Understood? Now let's move on to some more topics. Now here the next topic is conversion of mixed numbers. So in the we have studied about mixed numbers. It is a combination of whole number and proper fraction. Now, if you are asked to convert this mixed number in a proper or improper fraction, so how we will do? For example, I have taken 2/3/4. Here, 2/3/4 is taken as a mixed number and we have to convert it into a proper fraction. So, for example, for that, what we have to do? 2, we have to multiply with denominator, 2 × 4, and we have to add the numerator. Plus 3, divide by, the denominator remains the same, that is 4. So what you will get? 2 4s are 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, so you got 11/4. So it is converted into what? Improper fraction. How improper fraction? Because improper fraction are those which are greater than 1. So if you divide this 11/4, you will get a number which is greater than 1. Now for example, there is another question, 1/2/5. So, if we have to convert it into improper fraction, what we will do? 1 × 5 plus 2 divided by the denominator remains the same, is equal to 5. 1 5 are 5 plus 2 7, 7 by 5. Why it is improper fraction? But because if you divide this 7 by 5, you will get a value which is greater than 1. Okay, 17 by 10. If we are given an improper fraction and we are told to convert it into a mixed fraction, for that also we are having an exam process. So let's study that. For that, we have to divide the 17 by 10. 10 ones are 10. Okay, 7. Okay, just we have to do this much. And now we have to convert it into a mixed fraction form. For that, what we have to do? The remainder here will come at the top. Okay, this denominator remains the same, so we'll put it here. And the quotient part, 1 will come in the whole part. Okay, 1, 7 by 10. Understood how we got that? Yes. Now, there is another question, 6 by 5. We have to convert this improper fraction into mixed fraction. So what we will do, we will divide this 6 by 5. 5 ones are 5. 1. Okay, so now what we will do, remainder in the top, then the denominator remains the same, okay, 5, and the quotient part will come in the whole part. So 1 by 5. So in this way we can convert the mixed fraction for mixed number in the improper fraction, and if we are given an improper fraction, we can convert it into a mixed number. Hopefully you have understood what we have studied in this lecture. If you have any doubt, please let me know. Till then, take care, goodbye, and thank you.